Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning in the old cookbook show. Today we're going to do a recipe out of this little cookbook sent in by a viewer, and I thank you very much for sending this to us. It's called The Leamington Cookery Book by Miss Weston and Miss Sylvester, Principals of the Leamington and District School of Cookery. This was published in 1898 in Leamington, and the price was sixpence. Now, the foreword is written by Frances Evelyn Warwick, the Countess of Warwick. Part of the preface reads like this: "The art of cookery in England is, we are constantly being reminded, far behind that practiced in the continent, where the artisan's wife makes a tasteful dish out of what her English contemporary throws away. But these schools of cookery, which are springing up in all parts of the country, will go far to mitigate this reproach, and to teach more thrifty and practical habits, besides bringing within reach all of the classes many dainty dishes hitherto known in their kitchens." And I think that's kind of interesting. Even in, you know, when this was printed in 1898, they're realizing that a lot of cooks aren't using all of the products that are available to them, and sort of throwing some away and saying, that's not worthy of me using it. Whereas cooks in other parts of the world use everything and make fantastic dishes out of it. So there's a lot of really interesting recipes in this one, but I wanted to start with something fairly simple because I'm looking for a dessert today. And it's called baked lemon pudding. Now, this starts out in a pot. I'm gonna melt some butter in the bottom of the pot. And I'm gonna get a pint of milk. And this is an English or imperial pint, which is different than a US pint. There's a saying I see in the comment section all the time: a pint's a pound the world around. Except it isn't. It isn't actually a pound anywhere. The closest it gets to a pound is in the United States, because their pint is smaller than everyone else's. But in the rest of the world, a pint does not equal a pound. So that goes in, and I'm supposed to melt this together and bring it to a boil. So I'm going to watch this very carefully. Now, once this is brought to a boil, I'm supposed to add it to some breadcrumbs. And I've got fine breadcrumbs here, and I'm using fine breadcrumbs. This is always sort of that language that you have to interpret. I'm sure that some people would probably say I'm supposed to use bread crumbs that are more bread cubes. And I kind of thought that too, sort of like a bread pudding. But as I go through this book and I look at other recipes, they call out bread cubes in other places. So I'm assuming that a bread crumb is smaller than a bread cube. And I'm supposed to pour the hot milk over the bread crumbs. I'm going to simplify the recipe a little bit because it uses far too many dishes for my liking. So because this is a baked lemon pudding, we're supposed to use a lemon. So finely grated lemon zest, I'm going to add that to the breadcrumbs right now. Okay, the milk has come to a boil. So I'm going to pull that off the heat. And I'm supposed to pour the milk over top of the breadcrumbs and then add the sugar and the lemon peel. I'm just gonna pour it all into this pot just as a place to stir it all together. Okay, we'll mix that all together. Looking good. Now, I'm supposed to crack 3 eggs into a separate basin. One, two, and three, and then juice a lemon, or the lemon. Okay, so I'm supposed to beat these eggs with a whisk, and we'll whisk them up. This is a very simple, straightforward recipe. Now, in goes the lemon juice. And then I'm supposed to very quickly pour in the milk and breadcrumb mixture and mix it together so that the lemon juice doesn't have a chance to curdle the egg. It's gonna curdle the egg. Doesn't matter how fast you do it, there will be some curdling happening, but you know, try to mitigate that with stirring it quickly. So once I get this all stirred together, I'm supposed to bake it for about an hour in a moderate oven in a well-buttered pie dish. So I've got a pie dish here. Might not have been what they used in this time period, but it's kind of what I've got. So in this goes and then into the oven. And I've got a baking tray in the oven just in case this bubbles over. No clue what's gonna happen.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. It looks like a custard. Is it a custard?
Yeah.
You're not sure?
Well, it is kind of a custard because a custard has milk and eggs, and this has milk and eggs.
Okay.
But
so what's holding it together?
Breadcrumbs.
Okay.
Yeah. Breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
So let's give that a go.
And then I'm curious because I'm going to assume.
I like that.
That was better than I thought. In that, I was expecting a classic of a particular era when this might have been made, that it would have no flavoring in it.
Because
we've done many recipes like this that, in their kind of original versions, had no flavoring.
No
and
flavor.
Maybe and it's because they assume you would just put some in because it would make you happy.
Or you'd put something on top. Or they'd be very low in sugar. And this has sugar, so it's sweet, and it's got that refreshing lemon flavor.
It's pretty good.
Oh no, I think it's more than pretty good.
Glen does love a custard.
I think that's really good.
Yeah. No one's surprised there.
Yeah.
Glen loves a custard.
I really do love a custard. I don't know why the pie plate. Maybe you would have put it in a baked it in a more decorative pie plate than this. You can cook this in anything.
It also could just be a common thing that everyone would have.
Okay.
Yeah. A 9x9 may not have been that, or 8x8 may not have been that common.
Yeah. Baked lemon pudding. Now, okay, so this is from England in 1898. If you live in and around Leamington, is this something that's still made there? Do you remember this from your childhood? Do you remember it from now?
Do you make it with different flavors?
Yeah.
Because I imagine you could put, you know, rose water or whatever kind of flavor brings you joy into this.
You could make this with all kinds of different flavors. Is it something that still exists? Because I've never come across this particular style of custardy pudding with this range of flavor and the breadcrumbs. Other than bread pudding, or what we call bread pudding, that in Britain they call bread and butter pudding, which is, I just don't, you know, whatever. This is really good. I think this is a winner. This is well worth it. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.